quick, drop a like on this video in the next 5 seconds to claim the bonus present that Epic Games have secretly added. Don't miss out on this exclusive rare cosmetic, like the video right now. Do you want a free gift or cosmetic from the item shop? Well, I'm now gifting new subscribers every day. Simply make sure you hit the big red button and turn on all notifications, and let me know in the comments your Epic Games ID as well as what you'd like to receive off me from the item shop. We're also getting so close to 1.1 million subscribers, and the next person to subscribe will help us achieve the milestone and potentially be that 1.1 million subscriber. As the days pass throughout Winterfest, the main focus and everybody's attention has mainly been on the Crackshot Cabin, the presents we can open, and most importantly the two free skins, two of which are now available out of the two previously shown or firstly revealed in the Winterfest trailer. With that said, with the map being entirely covered in snow, not live within the game like we saw throughout Season 7 during the Ice Storm event, people only thought originally this was going to last for Christmas Day. This day only, the 25th of December, just like we saw last year before the Ice Storm event occurred in Chapter 1, Season 7. With the days passing, we are soon transitioning into the new year and creeping closer to the end of this particular season, the first one of this second chapter. And because of this, the snow is actually unveiling or foreshadowing something big upcoming by these storms frequently happening in-game, and well, let's just say we've cracked the code in terms of what's going to be happening based off a ton of hints and Easter eggs Epic Games have already added into their game, whether it be in our map right now or even foreshadowed throughout the weekly loading screens. Quickly, before we dive into any more of the juicy information, make sure to slap code FriendlyMachine in the Fortnite item shop if you directly want to support me as your favourite creator. As I'm an Epic Games affiliate now, it greatly helps fund all the gifts and V-Buck cards I give out here on the channel to you guys who comment your Epic Games ID down below. Want to be showcased on screen in the next video to show my appreciation directly in front of thousands of eyes? Well, make sure to tweet me proof of you rocking the code to my Twitter at FriendlyMachine in the video description down below, like these lovely people on screen right now. And I can't thank you guys enough for actually supporting me, and not only that, but tweeting me the proof, because this makes my day seeing this, as it really shows you guys are willing to go that extra mile. With that said, now let's dive into the complex storyline, of which has just really started, despite the season starting all the way back in October after the end event. Also, speaking of the past, we need to give a brief detour of why now, when snow is falling across our entire map, this is one of the most pinnacle moments not only of this season, but throughout the 10 seasons in bulk of this second chapter, and how it's going to progressively affect our storyline and map changes throughout all of them. The reason for this is because last time we saw snow fall anyways or wash up in any particular form for any permanent position, we had the iceberg obviously collide into our map in the Season 7 trailer that was foreshadowed, or basically put right in front of our eyes closely more approaching by the day toward the end of Season 6, where we could glitch outside the map and even get an early preview of what was going to be melted, being the tip of the Polar Peak Castle. And speaking of Polar Peak, well, as you guys know, this was the main name location that washed up, or basically was a part of the storyline, not only being a giant castle belonging to the Ice King and main protagonist, the Tier 100 skin of the Season 7 Battle Pass, but also with the days passing, with the layers being revealed from the ice melting of the depths of the ice castle, another protagonist, the secret skin, the prisoner, was introduced. With the constant development and excitement being basically showcased around this area in Season 7, we thought after the season ended with the prisoner skin escaping, all was done with. Well, it turns out we missed out on one of the biggest things possible, why the iceberg actually washed up at such velocity in the first place, and this was to do with something, a giant being frozen or trapped underneath with its head engulfed by the iceberg. This then was officially revealed two seasons later to be a living, breathing monster that's actually escaped from its cryogenic slumber or just simply woken up. This was all thanks to the volcanic eruption in Season 8, and if that hadn't woken up the Polar Peak monster, well, I don't know what would have, as it literally struck Polar Peak at the very point of which it was frozen. And I don't want to go too in-depth, but as you guys know, it escaped, it visited the island, and then, well, visited one final time before its particular demise in this universe or realm, which is important and we're also going to be talking about further on in the video. So that's a brief summary of everything that happened or was introduced for this snowy region, and these are some of the biggest affecting factors or most interesting ones that have happened in the whole Fortnite storyline thus far. With that said, if we apply that same context to now, Chapter 2, where snow is falling and blustering around, almost seeming like the storyline is starting for whatever reason, we can conclude this from looking at one of the particular loading screens, not only giving us a clue and indication as to what's developing, all the changes now not only being Christmas themed but a part of the storyline, but much more. As you guys can see, a data miner who's very reliable in terms of revealing things early actually annotated and analysed this particular loading screen that not many people could decipher before now. Full credit to Fortori for actually making sense of everything here, but it's become more obvious now despite this loading screen being available to unlock quite a while ago. The first indication we had pointing towards some importance from this loading screen was the coordinates of the back bling for the Serana or Alter Ego codename skin, and also the pickaxe or harvesting tool. From this making sense, and obviously most importantly, from the actual skin blocking something that seems interesting, players wanted to know what further importance or what further role these TV screens foreshadowed. And as you guys can tell by the look of the loading screen that is literally covered by one of the skin's heads, we can see a snowstorm forming, almost as if everything is being controlled by this character. Now, we knew it was inevitable that snow was going to fall this Christmas, but for a snow blizzard to be ongoingly happening every 15-30 minutes after Christmas Day, this is kind of strange. Also, in this particular loading screen, we can see the secret bunker that's being watched, maybe perhaps for something being trapped inside, as you can see also, potentially on the left-hand side, the building or the construction or the making of Chuggers happened or was experimented on inside the bunker, and they're trying to actually control it or make sure he doesn't break out. We then have the infection process or blueprints of the scratch skin, as you guys know, for getting to level 300, unlocking the 8-ball skin, then the variant for it, its alter ego version, the scratch skin, will grant you while this fully corrupted character. It's also foreshadowed here that yes, they're building a giant army through the amount of sludge characters, the alter ego version of Ripley, the happy and bubbly blue guy, and finally we have the analysis of the cube also being linked to be directly involved with the alters out of the alter versus ego people, considering their logo is plastered right on the left hand side. I know many of you will be thinking, well, this is only one loading screen out of many. Well, it's one of the most recent ones toward the end of the season, and typically these always give us small hints or small clues of what to expect, or basically indicate how the storyline is going to progress into the next season and throughout the weeks leading up until it. As you all know, Season 1 of Chapter 2 got extended from December 12, 2019, pushed all the way then until February 6, 2020. And the reason we know it's February 6th particularly is only thanks to data miners finding the exact display date in February from the files, as Epic Games did not declare this. Now, the main reason why I believe something big is brewing in the works or behind the scenes, masterminded by Epic Games, is because, well, they've just thrown a ton of content at us, and also a live event now, leading people to believe there won't be one related to the lore or the storyline of Fortnite's progression, basically making sense or explaining the map changes if looked into. For instance, we've had the Star Wars event to distract players with all the Star Wars cosmetics and even the free reward for actually attending the event, and of course not only the Winterfest event, but the free presents we can get from Crackshot's cabin despite the challenges we can complete to earn the free rewards, and many more exciting Christmas cosmetics that rotate throughout the item shop. With all this chaos happening, no pun intended, now would be the perfect time for Epic Games to start portraying the storyline of what's going to be happening and why things are happening the way they are in Chapter 2, as we still have so many unanswered questions, such as, why is there replicas or direct recreations or revamps of prior named locations that we've already seen, or just general structures, such as not only the landmark Risky Reels, the Drive-In Theatre, but entire named locations that haven't even changed their name slightly, such as Pleasant Park, Salty Springs and Retail Row. There's other locations such as Weeping Woods, where we can also see on the outskirts the tomato head mascot that was sucked into the black hole embedded in the ground from after it expanded and obviously was then thrust with great force embedded into the ground. And especially at Camp Cod, this seems like a kind of memorial area or region to lost relics from our prior universe or world. And that's kind of how we need to look at this, as an alternate universe or an alternate world of the world of Fortnite from Chapter 1. Sure, some things will be the same, but in this particular parallel universe or dimension, there will be new and unique factors, such as not only us seeing the Storm King appear from Save the World universe for the first time in Fort Nightmares, but also many more things to come in the future. Now, speaking of the Storm King, this actually correlates to our theory we're going to be talking about, mostly now that everything's been made sense of or explained to you guys, being perhaps responsible or even enforcing these storms in-game, these snow blizzards, the Snow King. I know many of you may be thinking, we've only just seen the introduction of the known Storm King from another Fortnite universe, which is possible for it to be making an appearance involved with the storyline in Battle Royale due to the mixing of these universes from the black hole occurring, shutting everything off, and then once it expanded, allowing everybody to hop back onto every realm or universe of Fortnite. Well, the reason this could be a factor is because Epic Games were maybe perhaps testing how the Storm King would be in preparation for this storyline affecting factor, and we know it's largely possible there's other versions of the Storm King due to all these dimensions now being kind of mashed together. Hence why we also have, as previously mentioned, these named locations revamped in a similar yet not exactly the same manner. The Fortnite storyline has always been its most interesting or at its peak point, and Epic Games know this when there's two giant protagonists involved that don't unveil their true identity until well very far in. And with that mentioned, now that we've brushed over the possibility of a Snow King being responsible for these map changes now, despite it being responsible for all of the storms or all of the spooky themed kind of storm map changes when the Storm King was around, what is the other giant being that it may also be fighting with that not only would make sense to fit into the storyline but has been teased to be making a return for quite some time now? Well, as you guys know, the Polar Peak Monster, despite it being slain in the final showdown to the hands of the Mecha Robot, we never not only learnt to the location of which the Mecha Robot travelled to or what universe or planet, but we never got any conclusion as to what was going on around its skeletal structure or bones after it deteriorated away, leaving behind this pink or radioactive substance trace affecting the environment. The strange thing about this also was toward the developments happening or the end event literally occurring with the rocket initiating it by launching, all the event files for everything involved were added back, not only just the rocket from Season 4's launch, not only the Cube Island that literally did nothing, but every event file from the final showdown, including Kata's codename for the Polar Peak Monster and Dogger's codename for the Mecha Robot. With this reaching the eyes of the community thanks to data miners over on Twitter, everybody was so hyped to see a final showdown V2 as well. The ending happened pretty quick in the first one. I know a live event can't go on for too long, but either way, it felt inconclusive. Many people waited in anticipation for something huge to happen, like the reversal of time to bring back the monster, but no, this never happened. But now that we've had a transition through time, not in reverse of it, with this black hole obviously sucking everything in and now transversing us over to this alternate parallel or different dimension, it's not only possible for another version of the Polar Peak Monster to be living around or in or under this Fortnite island that we're on now, but it's also being teased not only through a cosmetic pack being the Polar Legends, but even what foreshadowed the upcoming pack of the Polar Legends, this icy sculpture and the others contained in this particular snowy or icy area. Now, as we determined at the start of the video, these snowy or icy map changes always have great importance, more so than we know initially, in affecting Fortnite's storyline or the map changes that are going to portray that. Now, whilst it's unknown if we will be seeing another monster of the Polar Peak Monster's kind from Chapter 1 appear in Chapter 2, we do not have any indication as to how it may wash up or appear randomly around or on our Fortnite island. But if we look in the distance, well, there's a lot of structures similar to what could emerge, like the iceberg, which could seem unlikely considering we've already seen an event like this and everybody then would know what to anticipate. It's safe to say though that it's definitely largely implied to be involved with these snowy or icy map changes happening right now due to the Polar Peak Monster skin having a frozen variant, and with these textures being made to the Polar Peak Monster, this obviously could not only affect the skin by having the selectable style, but the actual giant monster that could be making an appearance, or even Garen be actually indicating before it's added or shows in our map or storyline that it is coming. I strongly believe this will be the case because Epic Games aren't stupid and they'll have some mega events this chapter, not only throughout even the end of this season to transition us into Season 2, the second season of this very second chapter, but even more so to conclude this chapter, which will be like literally in 3 years' time, in the second 10th season we've seen, in this chapter, Season X. It would also kind of make sense for two giant things to battle against each other, not only because of the popularity it garnered when actually happening live within the game for the final showdown, but we have two teams, the Alters and the Egos, or the Alter Egos and the Egos. So with two giant teams or formations or kind of organizations battling out, it would make sense for them to try and create something to stop everything once and for all, being something ginormous or having something ginormous on their side, whether it be the Snow King that could be implemented to the game or make an appearance, maybe perhaps even for an LTM, or the Frozen Monster. As of right now though, those are all the leads we have pointing toward this, and that's all I've got for you guys in today's video, but I'd love to know your thoughts and opinions on everything that's upcoming, not only to do with what's happening for New Year, what's happening after the Winterfest event, but the storyline progressing into our second season of this now second chapter. Anyways, if you enjoyed today's video or found it helpful or informative or even want to keep referring back to it to watch it again because I know we went very in-depth, make sure you leave a like in the video down below as the liked playlist is somewhere that people honestly remember to access more so than any other place to watch a video later. Also, make sure you're subscribing to the channel so you don't miss any further updates in terms of what's going on with our Fortnite map changes storyline and how everything links together and ultimately is made sense of ever since the start of it in Chapter 1 Season 4 with the Rocket launch. Hopefully I can also catch you guys remaining active in the comment section of my future videos to come when I post them, and I'm out. I hope you all have an amazing new year for when it comes around, and I'm out. Peace.